Africa today is facing challenges in mobilizing resources sustainably. And there has been a shrinking source of finances. Liberalization is still continuing under the EPS, because, for example, with the European Union, we have to liberalize 80% of our trade, at least for East Africa. Another area is the liberalization of services. We have liberalized banks, insurances, and all those telecommunication. And these are the sources of banks and insurance mobilize resources. But if you don't own that bank, you don't own those insurances, all that money is going out of the African continent.
The character and the ways in which we generate our resources give us three problems. One, foreign direct investment is key to most of the strategic areas where we generate investment. So mining, commodity exports, like coffee, cocoa. So in cocoa, for instance, African farmers farm cocoa. But the whole chain of distribution and export, all the way to the drink of the chocolate in Japan, is dominated by foreign. So those parts of our economy which actually generate foreign exchange are dominated by foreign investors and foreign companies. And they sit on the extra cash that is generated. Because of that, the money that we make from all these things is externalized, it's taken away. It's not reinvested. It's not available for reinvestment. The other areas that we generate economic activity, like in our farms, in a village farm, the returns that we have are not in the character that can be easily reinvestable. When my sister, for instance, does a farm and gets a tomato and sells it, what she wants to do is to go and buy a goat. And then keep the goat so that hopefully next year, the goat will get a small goatlet and a goatlet and a goat. That's her investment. Right? So when she comes to borrow money, she says, can you give me $2 and next year when I have a small goatlet, that's a guarantee. So that extra money that she gets, that economic resource, is not readily available. You and I cannot go and say, let us borrow the book to buy a car. But when you go to a bank to borrow money to buy a car, it's because somebody else has put money in the bank. Or when it's not in those forms, when they save, it's not big enough. So we have an economy where, because of the way the economy is structured as primary commodity export, but we've got a lot of money is kept outside. The ones that are inside are not readily available for investment. What our governments did after independence was to try and solve this problem. First, they tried to intervene to make sure that foreign profit repatriation is regulated. When Kaunda and Kwame Nkrumah and Nyerere came, they found all of tricks to make sure that you just don't take the profit away. Capital controls, foreign exchange controls, many things they did to make sure that when you make your profit, you can only take it away in managed forms. Then secondly, they decided to join in the making of the money. So the state intervened in being a mining company, joint enterprise. So the amount of money that a foreigner can take is divided between us. Now we also did some other thing, we started what we call development banking. The idea was that this development bank, what they did was to allow the local Ghanaians and Ugandans who are having small monies, put it together and make it available as investment bank money. And then the commodity boards. When the maize marketing board, the cocoa marketing board, what they did was that they went and bought the products from the farmers and they inserted themselves between the farmers and the foreign market. They gave the farmers a stable price, say 20 shillings per, I don't know, bag. And then when the world market was 50 shillings, they kept the 30 shillings difference. When the world market price was 5 shillings, they gave the difference to them. But what it meant is that they actually had money, which they then reinvested in many things. Almost all the hospitals in the villages, the roads and clinics were built from this amount of money. Basically, what it meant was that the government set up institutions which can help mobilize our resources to reinvest them in different places. The last one was that the central bank was given serious targets for development. It had a mandate which was creating jobs, employment, inflation and monetary were not the most important things. So it has a developmental mandate. The problem that we have now is that three things have happened in our economy in Africa since then, which is then have undermined these efforts for us to capture our resources to reinvest it. The first thing is that, Jay has mentioned, we've liberalized. We've closed down all the development banks and things like that because the IMF and the World Bank and some economists told us that that was generated financial market repression. It was distorting the financial market. People are not being encouraged to save and lend. So all the different bankings should be destroyed. So we closed the development bank before they distorted the market. Then we liberated the central bank from its developmental mandate and said that the most important thing is to attract foreign investment. And the foreign investor doesn't like anything more, anything that would eat away his or her profit. Inflation is the greatest enemy of profit. So therefore, from now on, you must target inflation. So all the central banks became targeters of inflation. They don't balance it, job creation, development, nothing. They are targeting inflation. But what is worse, in privatizing, this is a problem, in liberalizing, privatizing our banks, you see, when you sell your bank, you say, I want to give the private sector. The private sector in your country must have enough capital to be able to buy it. If the private sector in your country doesn't have enough capital to buy it, the foreign capital buys it. For instance, the Social Security Bank in Ghana that was established with workers' salary, we have been there for almost 13 years. When it was privatized, the only person to buy it was Société Générale in France. So all these foreigners came and bought our banks and then what? Listed it on their stock exchange. And then, an old French woman who has got a pension, then she invested it, make money for her pension, and then we pay her pension for her. So this privatization and listed it on the stock exchange meant that we've got a new way of getting our money again outside. Then the third set of problems were even worse. We have now also established what we call financial instruments and financial centers, right? So Anita can sit in New York. When she gets a little salary, she can buy Ghana government bonds in dollars. Huh? She can actually come and the Ghana Stock Exchange sit in New York and buy shares in our companies. So she's sitting and all the money that we are generating, she's getting the profit to her. Right? Also now, domestic people, you and I think some of us have dollar account in our economies. Huh? In Ghana, for instance, everybody's wife has to open a dollar bank account. Now, residents are now being allowed to open foreign exchange accounts. The final one is that now, and this is a problem about investment. We used to think that investment was when the person came, foreign investment. He came to build a factory in the economy. Now, it's no more. In fact, foreign direct investment legally is defined as anything that's more than 10% ownership control of the shares. There's another form of foreign investor that we can look at now, where the person comes, buy the, Uganda shillings, buy a lot of Uganda shillings, plenty of it, and is waiting, sitting down, waiting. When the exchange rate between Uganda shillings and Kenya shillings changes a bit, then he sells it off, sell it, and makes a lot of profit, and go on. It's called carry trade. And the Bank of Ghana is encouraging people to come and do carry trade. In other words, our financial system has been destroyed from the very bottom up.
Also, when you look at the way we manage our resources as Africa, we no longer put even the little resources we have in the productive sectors, in agriculture, in industry, in the trade. For example, in Uganda here, trade, the Ministry of Trade is a non-focal sector, and it gets almost about 0.4% of the total budget. So if we are not generating resources internally, then we go for external resources. These are loans, aid, PPPs, which have also very, very negative implications. So Africa, we are caught in a trap. The public revenue deficit trap. We don't have money, we borrow,
When we borrow, we have to pay back, we have conditionalities, and the cycle, the trap continues. And the conditionalities also affect our structural transformation. Because the conditionalities are, I'm giving you this money, don't put it in agriculture, don't put it in industry, put it in roads, infrastructure. And who is doing the infrastructure? Exim Bank lends us money, the Chinese company works on that road. That money doesn't come here at all, but we continue paying. And also the whole issue of the PPPs, you know, who is carrying the risks? We carry the risks here, and then we have to pay. So what alternative financing system we underpin Africa's structural transformation? Because when we are talking about structural transformation, the financial system is very, very, very critical. So we need to rethink the reforms which we undertook in the mid-1980s. Not just in the economy, but in trade and industry, but also in the financial sector. We need to revisit those policies which we had prior to the 1980s.
We want to structurally transform our economy. We want to be able to reconnect finance back to production. Secondly, the formal sector, where the formal finance is still small, right? As we said, 70% of the economically active population in Africa are in small-scale farming. How do we provide financial services and instruments for them that can help them mobilize their funds, put it in banks for reinvestment? How do we reorganize rural production to make it more collective so that we can have investment finance for it? And how, in the process of the discussion of CFDA, can we have that?